students. Today we shall discuss the conservation laws that are to be followed by the elementary particles. Certain elementary particles are under the effect of the certain or the four fundamental types of the interactions. The interactions are the gravitational interaction, electromagnetic interaction, weak interaction and strong interactions. So all the elementary particles are not under the effect of all type of interaction. So there are certain conservation laws that are followed by the elementary particles, or they are followed by all the types of interactions. And there are certain interactions that are not followed by all types of interactions. So let us look what are these conservation laws. So the first conservation law is the mass energy conservation law. So every conservation law means that if we have a decay process, if we have a certain process where there is some reactants and there are some products, then the value of the certain variable which has to be conserved must be same on the reactant side as well as on the product side, such that the sum of the value of that variable should be equal to each other on the reactant as well as on the product side. So in the mass energy conservation, the value of the energy, that is the sum of the energy on the reactant side, should be equal to the sum of the energy on the product side. Or we can say that the summation of E is constant. For the second conservation law, that is for the linear momentum, again it is same that the linear momentum, the sum of the linear momentum on the reactant side should be equal to the sum of the linear momentum on the product side. Or we can say that the summation of the linear momentum will be equal to constant. Next conservation deals with the angular momentum. Again same, that the sum of the angular momentum of the reactants must be equal to the sum of the angular momentum on the product side. Or we can sum it as the summation of the angular momentum is constant. So next conservation is the electric charge, or we can say the atomic charge. So atomic number we can say. So the atomic number or the electric charge, that is the sum of the electric charge on the reactant, must be equal to the sum of the electric charge on the product side. So that means that the summation of the Q should be equal to constant. That is, the charge should be constant. Next is the conservation of the lepton number. So the conservation of the lepton number means that if there are leptons in the reactant side as well as there are some leptons in the product side, so the lepton number should be balanced, means that the sum of the lepton numbers on the reactant side should be equal to the sum of the lepton number on the product side. It can never be possible that the lepton number is not conserved. And you know that in the lepton family, electron, positrons, mu minus, mu positive, meson and the neutrinos come in the category of the lepton. Whereas if we consider the baryon conservation, similarly that was in the lepton number, same is the conservation for the baryon number, that if there are baryons on the reactant side, there should be baryons on the product side, and the sum of the baryon number on the reactant side should be exactly equal to the sum of the baryon number on the product side, or the summation of the baryon number should be constant. So all these six laws are conserved for all the four types of fundamental interactions. So it is not possible that if any of the interaction is not conserving any of the following conservation law, then that interaction cannot be possible, that decay cannot be possible, that process cannot be possible. So for a process to be followed, that the decay or the reaction to take place, these six conservations has to be conserved, otherwise the particular process cannot take place. There are certain other conservations. So next we talk about the total isospin. As you can see in this table also, we have already calculated the isospin, total isospin, and the Z component of the isospin. So we can also take the conservations for the isospin and the Z component of the isospin. So for the total isospin, again same that the isospin, sum of the isospins on the reactant should be equal to the sum of the isospin on the product side. Or we can say that the summation of the total isospin should be constant. And this is true for this, this should be valid, this is conserved, always conserved for the strong and electromagnetic interaction, whereas in the weak interaction, this total isospin is not conserved. Similarly, for the Z component of the isospin, that the IZ value, that is the sum of the IZ value on the reactant should be equal to the sum of the IZ value on the product side, or the summation of the IZ is constant. And for the hypercharge or the strangeness, it is same, that the values, that the sum of the values of the hypercharge on the reactant should be equal to the sum of the hypercharge on the product side. And similarly, it is for the strangeness also. So that the summation of Y and the summation of S should be constant. All these four components, these four conservations for the isospin, the R component of the isospin, for the hypercharge and for the strangeness, this has to be conserved for the strong or the electromagnetic interaction. If a particular process is decaying through the strong interaction or electromagnetic interaction, we have to prove that these components are also conserved. Otherwise, the reaction for the strong electromagnetic interaction will not be conserved, will not take place if the isospin, hypercharge and strangeness are not conserved. So the process would be then said to be decaying by the weak interaction, because for the weak interaction, the isospin, hypercharge and the strangeness is not conserved. Last, we want to quote that for the weak interaction, all these four isospin component, R component of the isospin or the hypercharge, the strangeness is not conserved, and then the reaction will decay through the decay through the weak interaction. And for the strangeness, the weak interaction has a selection rule, where the selection rule is given by that the change in the value of the strangeness, that the reactant and the product side, if they are not conserved, they would be differing by some certain value. So the value by which they can differ for the weak interaction is by the change of either plus minus 1 or 0. Either it will be conserved, both will be balanced, the strangeness will be balanced on the product side and the reactant side. And if it is not conserved, then for the strangeness, the maximum permissible value for the change in strangeness could be just either plus 1 or minus 1. So for weak interaction, the selection rule for the strangeness is plus minus 1 or 0. Or for the stronger electromagnetic, isospin, hypercharge and strangeness also has to be conserved. And these six, the baryon number, lepton, electric charge, angular momentum, linear momentum, mass energy, they have to be conserved for any type of the interaction, whether it is strong, it is gravitational, it is electromagnetic or weak. So, but for the weak interaction, these factors are not conserved, and the for the weak interaction also, if we want to conserve it, so the strangeness has a selection rule of plus minus 1 or 0, that the change in the strangeness can take the value of plus 1, minus 1 or 0. So now we do some of the reactions and see whether the following reactions are conserved under which process. Let us now see some of the reactions. So here we have a reaction that the proton and proton creates lambda naught, K naught, a proton and a pi positive meson. So now let us see which conservation laws are balanced or conserved. So this is the charge. So we can see the proton has charge 1, lambda naught, K naught has charge 0, where proton and pi positive also has charge 1 positive. So the charge is balanced, so it is conserved. For the lepton, leptons comes the electron, positron, mu minus, mu positives and the neutrinos. So there are no electron, positrons or neutrinos. So the lepton number is 0. In the baryon family, as you can see here also, in the baryon family we have proton, neutron and the lambda particle. But the K particle and the pi particles are in mesons. So the K and pi, we have the baryon number 0. And all are particles, so we can see that the baryon number is 2 on the left hand side and 2 on the right hand side. So the baryon number is also balanced, it is conserved. Now for the I value, the total I isospin, for P you can see here the proton has a value of half. So it is half and half. Again proton has value half. Lambda naught is not having any of the value of I is 0 here, so I value is 0. K naught is k0 value is again half. So it is 0, it is half, proton is half, and for pi positive it is 1. But we can see here the I is not conserved. So I is not conserved. For the I, z component of the isospin, we have again the half values. For proton it is plus half, and for k0 it is minus half, and for the pi positive the I z value is plus 1. So here we can see that half and half gets cancelled. So on the left hand side it is plus 1 value, and it is on the right hand side also it is plus 1 value. So I z value is conserved. So for the Y reaction, for the hypercharge for protons it is 1 value, hypercharge take the value 1, and for k0 it is 1, and for pi's and lambda naught it is 0. Here you can see the value for hypercharge. For proton it is 1. For the lambda naught, the hypercharge value is 0. And for k0 also the value is plus 1. So it is plus 1 here. So we can see that the hypercharge is balanced. For the strangeness involves only the baryons and the K particles. So strangeness for protons, it is the strangeness number is 0. Lambda naught is minus 1, k0 is plus 1 and 0. So strangeness is also conserved. So we can see here that the I value is not only conserved, rest all the factors are conserved. So next, if we consider the second type of reaction, we see here that the sigma positive is decaying by proton and pi naught. So on the charge balancing, which has to be compulsory balance for any type of interaction, sigma positive has one charge, proton has one charge, and pi naught is 0, so the charge is balanced. Lepton number has to be also balanced, so we can see here that they do not have any leptons. So lepton number is 0, that is conserved on the left hand side and right hand side. Baryon number, for baryon number, sigma positive is 1, proton is 1, pi naught is not a baryon particle, it is 0, so the baryon number is also conserved. So now we see for the I value, for sigma positive it is 1, for p positive it is plus half, and for pi naught it is plus 1. So this value I is not conserved. And also the IZ value is also not conserved here. You can see the values. For hypercharge also, sigma positive takes the value 0, p positive also takes the value of plus 1, and pi naught is 0. So hypercharge is also not conserved. Even the strangeness is also not conserved. So the reaction cannot take place through the strong or electromagnetic interaction. So if the decay process is taking place, so the decay process will take place by the weak interaction, not by the strong or electromagnetic interaction.